Hi there, my name is Dimitris Karalabidis, I'm an IB and SAT mathematics teacher, and in this video we are going to discuss about the local maximum and minimum points of a graph. In one of the previous videos, we examined the relation between the sine of a function's derivative and the function's monotonicity. More precisely, we learned that when f prime of x, when the derivative of f is bigger than 0, then that means that in that specific interval in which that relation applies, f is increasing. Similarly, when f prime of x is negative, then f is decreasing. What happens though when f prime of x is 0 at a certain point? To understand that, we must try to find the geometrical explanation of this expression. Let's assume that at a certain point x0, we have the derivative of f being equal to 0. We have f prime of x0 equals 0. We have already defined that f prime of x0, the value of the derivative of a function f at a given point x0, is the slope, or in other words, the gradient, of the tangent line to the graph of f at that point with coordinates x0 and f of x0. Hence, f prime of x0 equals 0 can geometrically mean that at that point with coordinates x0 and f of x0, the tangent line that can be drawn has a gradient of 0, has a slope of 0. We also know from theory of lines that a gradient of 0 basically means that the line is parallel to the x-axis. And to move further, we could say that f prime of x0 equals 0 could geometrically mean that at that point with these coordinates x0 and f of x0, the tangent line that is drawn is parallel to the x-axis. So once again, f prime of x0 is 0 can geometrically mean that at the point with x coordinate equal to x0, the tangent line that is drawn is parallel to the x-axis. But where does a drawn tangent line is actually parallel to the x-axis? Well, that can happen in the following cases. In the first case, we have the points where the graph of a function presents local minimums or local maximums. We can see here that I have already drew two cases, one on the left where the graph presents a local minimum and one on the right where the graph presents a local maximum respectively. And we can see that if we draw the tangent lines at these specific points, obviously these lines will be parallel to the x-axis. So is this all? No, because there is the second case, which is a peculiar one, and that's because in this case the original function is a constant one. For example, it could be the function f of x equals 5. In this case, since as we know the derivative of a constant number is equal to 0, here as well the derivative of this function, of this constant function, will be equal to 0 at any given point. To combine these two cases we just mentioned, we can come up with an interesting condition of algebraically finding local minimums or local maximums on a graph of a function. All we need to do is find the points at which the derivative of the initial function is equal to 0. In fact, these points where the derivative of a function is equal to 0 are called stationary points. Once again, stationary points of a graph are the points on that graph at where the derivative of the function is equal to 0. It is quite obvious that if a function does not have any stationary points, if we cannot find any points at where f derivative is equal to 0, then its graph cannot have any local minimums or local maximums either. But is that all? Is finding the stationary points of a graph enough to determine the local minimums or local maximums? Well, it's a start, but not enough. We have to keep in mind that if at x0 we have f prime of x0 equals 0, then there are actually three options, three choices. Option number one, at x0, the graph of f has a local minimum. Option number two, at x0, the graph of f has a local maximum. And option number three, none of the above. At x0, the graph of f is simply parallel to the x-axis. So now, finding just the stationary points is not enough to determine the graph's local minimum or local maximum. Assuming that we have managed to find some stationary points for a function, we can further classify them using either the table of signs of the derivative function or by applying the second derivative rule. And both these approaches will be further analyzed in some of the next videos. For the moment, we should keep the following. Given a function f, first of all, we need to know what stationary points are, and they are the points where f prime of x is equal to 0. So, if we are asked to simply find the stationary points, that's all we're going to do. We will calculate the derivative of f, we will make that equal to 0, and we will simply solve that expression. Then, we need to know that stationary points can be classified either as local minimums or local maximums or none of the above, just some points at where the graph is parallel to the x-axis. Now, in order to find the local minimums or local maximums, one should follow the steps below. At first, we should start by calculating the first derivative, f prime of x. Then, we should solve f prime of x equals 0 because we need to calculate the stationary points. Because, as we mentioned, if we cannot find any stationary points, then that only means that there aren't, the graph does not present any local minimum or maximum. And then, once we have the stationary points, we have to classify them one by one, either by using the table of signs of the derivative of the function, or by simply applying the second derivative rule. Now, keep in mind that if we said that if we know that f prime of x0 is 0, then that could mean that either at x0 we have a local minimum or a local maximum or nothing. But in the opposite direction, if it is known that at x0 the graph has a local minimum or local maximum, then for sure the value of the derivative over there, f prime of x0, will be equal to 0. And that would be all. For any questions you might have regarding the content we just viewed or any possible collaboration, you can always contact me. Do not forget to check my site www.haralambidisdimitris.com for more IB and SAT math resources, and of course subscribe to this channel. As always, thank you for your time.